Okay, talking about the weather shortly with Tim Bailey, but in the meantime, Tim is reliving a grand maritime story.
Welcome aboard, ladies and gentlemen, the James Craig, one of Sydney's best sea stories, I believe. 1874 she was commissioned. She took cargo all over the world, went round the Horn 23 times, did work in Papua New Guinea, ended up wrecked in Tasmania as a coal hulk. And then these people got involved, these wonderful people. On your television, Nick Papagiorgio, who is the operations manager. 30 years to restore this fine vessel, the James Craig. The people, congratulations everyone, give yourselves a round of applause. $23 million.
It's
the patience. Tell me about the passion and the patience.
Well, the thing about this restoration is it's always been about the people and people willing to back the project. I mean, 30 years is a long time. It could have fell over at any tick of the clock. We were strapped for cash for a lot of that period. And it was only people that held the whole thing together.
You get very little government funding, so you're self-funded, art unions and that sort of thing. Man hours. How many man hours over 30 years?
I don't think it's ever been calculated, but I'd assume it'd be in the millions if you were to think about how many people worked through it through the 30 years. And different people involved, volunteers, work police from the jail systems, and all sorts of groups work across this. An awful lot of people have had a contribution to this restoration, and it's world class.
And on Friday, what a celebration, the 10th anniversary of its recommissioning to take paying fares out on Sydney Harbour, 10th year party, that'll be a beauty. Once again, round of applause, congratulations everyone. A 30 year journey, I mean it's a lifetime of work, you should be enormously proud.
Yeah.
The Northeaster is piping down the harbour at the moment, the story is all about the weather, and we have got thunderstorms rolling from North Sydney all the way up to the Hawkesbury. The northern beaches have absolutely been pummeled in the last half an hour. We've just had a report from Sydney Ambulance that a lady was on the phone at Arncliffe. A lightning strike hit the roof of her house and she's being attended to for hearing damage. So it's a night of caution again in Sydney as thunderstorms roll through the district. Let's get into your backyard right now. And current temperatures, 26 degrees Gosford. We've got 23 Richmond and 21 in Sydney where a thunderstorm warning is in place. The wind to northeaster, don't worry about that southeast, it swung to the northeast. Bailey's barometer 1017. Let's have a look at the satellite for you. Cloud over New South Wales in a trough triggers widespread storms, some potentially severe. Map tomorrow, a trough will spread showers, storms and a cooler change across WA into South Australia. Hot northerly winds will build in South Oz ahead of this. The rainfall map then, more storms and showers for New South Wales tomorrow, delivering generally less than 15 millimetres, but there could be bullseyes higher than that in the north. So, while these storms have moved to the northern suburbs, northern beaches and up into the Hawkesbury, a second line of storms could hit the western suburbs in the next hour or two. Severe thunderstorm warning for all New South Wales districts apart from the Riverina and the northern rivers. Let's go interstate for you right now. And tomorrow in Brisbane, we have got possible shower. Thunderstorms in Canberra, clearing shower Hobart, mostly cloudy Adelaide. Cloud increases in the Alice. Possible shower Lismore and then thunderstorms right across New South Wales. Coffs Harbour, Tamworth, Dubbo, Orange, Canberra, Nowra, Bega, thunderstorms. Gosford tomorrow, 28. 30 degrees Richmond, 29 at Bankstown. Sydney tomorrow, cloudy with northwesterly winds, isolated light showers early, thunderstorms in the afternoon, 27. 5:46 sunrise, set 7:33. Sunny Friday, possible storm Saturday, sunny Sunday, possible storm Monday, storms Tuesday and Wednesday. That's it from me aboard the James Craig, and happy 60th birthday to the best floor manager in Australian television history, Tommy Evans. Round of applause, please.
Absolutely, Tommy's standing behind. He's hiding from us all. We gotta go. Good night.
Good night.